Hello. Hi, everyone. Hello, hello, hello. How are you guys doing today? Hi, everybody. Thank you so much for joining me today. Hey. Hi.
Hello, hello. How are you guys doing today? Hi, everybody. Thank you so much for joining me today.
There we go. I had to put myself on mute. Oh, hi, honey. Thank you. Thank you. Hi, guys. How are y'all doing? For those of you watching for the first time, I am Pam, and this is the Pam FAM. Thank you so very much for joining me. If you're joining from Twitter, from Facebook, hello. Hi, hi, hi. How are you doing? I'm so happy you joined us today. If you are watching the replay, please, my dearies, don't forget to hit like, comment, and subscribe, please, if this is the kind of content you like. So, guys, again, I am Pam. Let's see who we got in the room. Well, y'all know I got to put glasses on because I can't see. Let's see who's here today. Oh, my goodness. We've got LaTanya. Yes. Hi, Random Lifestyle Vlog. Hello. Hi. Hi. Hi, Mighty Strong. Hello, Abina. Hi. That's my new friend from last night. Hi, Marilyn. Hey. We've got LaTanya. I said hi. Hi, my dear. Hello, hello. Hello, Cynthia. Hi. Oh, this is pretty awesome. Yes. Hi, D'Angelo. Hi, Brit. Yes. Yes, I'm feeling quite Bridgerton-ish. Princess-ish today. Yes, Brad, he is awesome. Let's see what he got me today. He got, oh, this is from Tropical Cafe. We have a Tropical, I love their stuff, especially their wraps. Oh my goodness, yes. Hi, Lindsay. Hi. Okay. So everyone is saying hello to each other. That is pretty awesome. Guys, how's your Sunday doing today? As you can see, the lighting was not agreeing with me, and I've got a lot of stuff in the back because we're going to go through some of that stuff today. And we are talking about, what are we talking about today? We're talking about our hot springs things. Yes, yes, we are. So let's do this. Let's put a banner up so that when folks come in, we don't have to, you know, repeat ourselves or anything. I should have done that earlier. Did not think about that. Hot springs things. Because you know, it's getting warm. I don't know where y'all at, but it's getting warm over here. Warm to the extent that I broke out my hand fan. Yes, I bring out, yes, yes, yes. Yes, I brought it, I had to break it out. Okay, so hot spring things, fragrance, fashion. And fabulousness. That's what we're doing today. And let's save that and show. And there we go. Yay. So, guys, let's see. I saw some new comments come in. Hi, Savvy Specialist. Okay, so it's okay. So you've had a lazy day. Oh, okay. We have had beautiful, beautiful weather all day, all weekend actually. So that was really good. Chia Banana Boost from Tropical Smoothie. This one is probably the either the Bahama Mama, or there's a new one that they have out. I don't remember what it is, but hi, thank you. Thank you. Thank you so very much. Oh, yes. Please, guys, don't forget to thumbs up. Thank you so very much. Please remember to thumbs up. I know. I know. Giving princess vibes. You know, had to get, this was, to, you know, I'm brown skin, you know, so the makeup, I don't want the makeup getting on the shirt, so I flipped it down. It normally sticks all the way up. Hi, Nika. So, guys, let me tell y'all. Normally during the spring and the summer, we tend to want to make things really, really easy on ourselves. That's with hair, that's with makeup, that's with skin. But because it's normally hotter, we normally find that we're breaking out more. We get sunburnt because a lot of times we walk out of the house, we do all of this skincare and stuff that has AHAs, BHAs, et cetera, and forget to put sunscreen on. So we end up getting burnt. So we end up spending a lot more time trying to reverse the damage that we were actually fixing with all the skincare we was working on, right? Because we don't put sunblock or sunscreen on. And in today's video, we're all also going to be talking about what are the other things that you do in the spring. We do fragrance, of course. We talk about that all the time, but we also talk about being fabulous. That means taking care of your skin and, of course, dressing. And I have a lot of what I think is that you can get the same things, use the same stuff over and over again. But not only that, but you can also, hear this, you accessorize. That's it. Accessorize. Necklaces, scarves, rings, earrings. You know, these are my statement pieces. I love hoops. You know, people talk about statement fragrances. I have statement hoops. The bigger, the better. But now as I'm getting older, I can't wear the really heavy ones. So let's see. Did I miss anyone? Hi, Priya. Yes, I did. I changed it just for today. You know, I'll see how I like it. Do you guys like it? You know, looking little princess vibes. Do you like it? This is a present for my daughter. This was one of my Christmas presents, believe it or not. And I absolutely love it. It's nice and soft. It smells really good. The hard part was getting it to put it on, to be honest with you. That stuff is hard to do. I don't know how they... Helen, I don't know how you do it. If you're here tonight, girl, I don't know how you do it. It's hard. Gosh. Oh, thank you so very much. So talking about skin, I'm going to move quick today because we're only going to be here, even though I have all of this stuff to talk about, we're only going to be here for about an hour and a half. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so very much. Yes. See, we need to start a... Yes, we do. Let's do that. Hashtag glam Pam. How about we do that? Yes. I like that because I glam on a budget. I try to anyways. So let's get started. The first thing I want to talk about is after you wash your face, a lot of times you think washing your face, it doesn't really matter what soap you're using. And to an extent, that is true, except if the soap has a lot of ingredients in it that's going to cause your skin to dry out, especially for those of us that are in our 30s, 40s, 50s, 60s, and above, okay? So one of the things that I do is I use several different soaps, but I use Exuviance, I use Eve Loam. They're just trying not to make me be great today. But one of the things I must do is I put essence on my skin after I wash my face. After I wash my face and I do my masking, and I love to mask, you guys know that. But I use Eve Loam, Time Retreat, upside down, there we go, Time Retreat. Right, and this one is the Radiance Essence. So I use this, and you don't have to buy this. You can buy any essence that has the ingredients that your skin needs. If it needs more AHAs, more BHAs, more rose water, more moisture, whatever you want to do. But the bottom line is use an essence. Pour a couple drops of this in your hand, pat it on your face. I do it about, normally I do about five iterations. If I'm in a rush, 2 to 3 iterations, but I pat it in. Once I'm done doing that, my skin is plumped up. You hear me? It's like you took my skin to Goodyear, you put some air in it, and it sucks the moisture from the air in, you know, into my, I just look nice. It has hyaluronic acid. It's got all the good stuff in it. And that's why I love this. And this is my last bottle, I think. This is my last bottle. So I'm like nursing this. I also use an essence from Exuviance. I also have one from Shiseido. I love essences. I love, love, love skincare. So I always am an advocate for anyone to utilize skincare. And that is Eve Loam's Time Retreat. And this one is the Radiance Essence. Now, after you use the essence, hold on. This high neck here making me hot. I'm going to put this fan on. So you'll hear, woo. This is what I remind, you know, when I was coming up in the, you know, come up to the U.S. and stuff in Miami, that's what you see young, you know, younger, more mature ladies would have their fan in the hair salon. Okay. See, goes up. Yes. One of the staff members, she purchased this for me, and it's the best gift ever. So after I'm done with that, you put on whatever skin cream, whatever you want to do, whatever serums you want to do, you put that on. And once you're done doing that, the last thing you've done before you walk out your house, even if you're staying in your house, light, outside light, those rays are also going to be harmful to your skin. The warmer it gets, the hotter the rays are going to be. So you pull out your sunscreen. And as you can see, I'm almost done with this. And my sunscreen is also by Eve Loam. Guys, I found this at TJ Maxx. So I'm almost, I think I'm down to here. And what I do, I don't play around. I will cut this and I will get every single last ounce out of that $30 I spent for it. Because this online, I think these are like $60 or $70. So skin cream, skin care, and then follow it up before you walk out that house or before your last thing before you put on your makeup or your, how do you call it? Your primer, which I have right here, should be your sunblock. Okay, let's see. I got some more comments in here. Yeah, look at the fan here. It is getting hot outside. I can tell because I'm burning up. Hi, Cece. Yes, hashtag glam Pam. Yes, Lancome does. Lancome has really good products. Yes, hashtag glam Pam. I'm telling you, Lancome has great products. I use Lancome, Estee Lauder, Shiseido. Before I started venturing into Sunday Riley and all that, that's the kind of stuff. Oh, maybe it's all his hair that's got me hot. I literally used that on a daily, okay? Hold on. Your girl's got, I'm burning up. Yes. So the next thing you want to do after your skincare, of course, you want to put on what? You want to put on your primer. If you put on makeup, you put on your primer. You see, I'm already glistening, right? So you put on your primer. Right now, I use Tash. I have about 7 or 8, maybe, no, I have about 12 primers. Let me not lie. About 12 primers. This one is a good one. For those of us that have larger pores, it fills in your pores. You rub it in, and then you press in. If it starts balling up because it's not really meshing well with your skincare or whatever, you press it in. Let it sit, and once it sits, then you go in with your makeup, okay? So always wear primer, especially in the heat, to keep your makeup looking flawless. And when you put primer on, in my opinion, even on top of sunscreen, depending upon if your sunscreen oily, okay? It will do what? It will hold on to that makeup. So let's see here. Hi, Crystal. Aw, thank you, hugs. Tosh is here. Hi, Tosh. Let's see. Sunscreen is a must. I use it even when I'm inside. Yes, it's very important. I didn't really used to do that, right? And then after I started using all these products with these AHAs, BHAs, all that kind of stuff, and I started researching, I'm an enthusiast. I love skincare. I love makeup and stuff like that. But I noticed a difference when I really paid attention to utilizing sunscreen on my skin. Let's see here. Nika's in here. Hi, Keitra. Hi. Oh, look, this is going to be Beyonce. Hey. Oh, gosh. Hit that thumbs up. That's right. The wigs, they look so wiggy on you. Well, this one was looking wiggy on me. It took me about an hour to put this one on. You know, I'm not very good at, you know, doing these, but I'm getting to it because I love changing up my looks. And not having to damage my hair, you know, like perming it and all that kind of stuff. Let's see here. Anything else? Yes. Hold on. There we go. Beyonce has like about 25 fans. Okay. So after we're done with that, you know, your makeup and stuff like that, I talked about good quality foundation. Now you can buy inexpensive foundation at a drugstore. If that works for you, that works for you. But my thing is that when you wait until like Nordstrom, Bloomingdale's, Neiman Marcus, Saks Fifth Avenue, Sephora, cosmetics company, all of these places, they have huge sales, especially because of the Corona, they have huge sales. So this right here, this is by Sisley. This is the Phyto Tinted Cloth. Okay, guys, this foundation, $122 originally, right? Then it went down to $60 or $66. And then I got an additional 25, 30% off. And then one time they had it in Nordstrom's sales section marked down 50% off the lowest price or whatever. So I bought two of them. So I have two backups. Plus I have this one I'm trying to finish. The other thing that you can do for foundation, okay, NARS. NARS, the packaging changes out and stuff like that. They always release something every year, I think. I find my NARS foundation, TJ Maxx. Yes, ma'am. I bought two of them from Sephora when they had the 20% off sale. But this one I paid $14.99 for at TJ Maxx. And let me tell you, every time I put this on, I get compliments. People say my skin look good because my skin doesn't look cakey, you know, at all. It gives me a nice, even complexion, and I absolutely adore it. And this one here, let's see. Nope, I can't see it from there. I have to put my glasses on. This one, my color is Macau. I'm normally MAC NC50. I used to think I was NW45. Turns out I was too red. Ah, this is a semi-matte, and it's called the All Day Luminous Weightless Foundation. Okay? Can you see that? All right. And I am the color. I could wear two colors. Three. I could wear Macau. I think I could wear Trinidad. And there's another one I can wear, like three different colors. And I play with my foundation because I like to mix. I truly, truly like to mix. So those two foundations, because they're lightweight, they're semi-matte, so they're not going to give you that cakey appearance. But you don't want to put on a glossy during the summer, during the spring and summer when it's warm. You don't want to be putting on glossy foundation. And then you're putting on glossier like highlights and all that. You'll be looking quite J-Lo disco glow kind of, you know, I think. So let's see here. Yes, I might. This one was a gift. My daughter got me this for Christmas and I absolutely love it. I love the way it feels. It was easy to put on, but I think my head is bigger than the wig, you know. But I'm learning. Hi, Jen. Thank you for joining. Hello, my dear. Let's see. We don't have Sephora in the UK. Do you have an equivalent of Sephora? Where do you guys get your beauty products and stuff from? Hi, Teresa. Random lifestyle vlog. Wherever you have the equivalent, you might be able to get it there. But I think that you guys have an equivalent. It's not called TJ Maxx, but it's called something else, right? So I always talk about searching in those areas. Now, after you're done with your, you know, your face and your skincare and stuff, I thought I brought it here, but body, even though it's hot, there are body oils you can use. There are skin cream you can use. I still use butters because I'm older, so my skin is drier, and I do drink a lot of water, but I still got drier skin. So I really try to ensure that I'm moisturized. And even when I put a lot of moisturization on my skin, even if it's a lightweight one, like this one I found at TJ Maxx, it's called Coconut Moisturizing Lotion by Harper and Ari. Even when I use this stuff, my skin dries out, you know? So that's one of the things that I have to be very, very careful about. So that's the foundation. Now, hold on, let me pull this basket up here on my lap so I can show you guys as I talk. Okay. All right. So, foundation. We talked about foundation. One of the things that I learned about makeup, when you're putting makeup on, whether you're a guy or a gal, when you're putting makeup on during the summer, it tends to come off. You can put powder on, but it's better if you put something that's cream or cream-based. And then you put the powder on top. If you want your makeup to last all day, if you want your stuff to last all day, you know, some guys, they wear like bronzers and stuff like that, you know, to give them that beautiful, like sun-kissed glow, sometimes a little bit of highlighter, sometimes the fragrance oils that they may use may have just a tiny bit of shimmer in it, not glitter, but shimmer in it and stuff like that. But I noticed that these are the products that I think keeps me glam during the summer, okay? And spring and summer. And that is products by Natasha Denona. This is the Bloom palette. Absolutely love this. Comes with, let me flip this up a little quick. These two down here, these two parts right here, this is a cream and this is a cream. These two at the bottom, creams, right? And these two are like highlighters, but I have used them as top. I've used them bottom line toppers or highlighters. I can't use them as blush because they're a little, they're orange, which I like, but you see the dimension, very, 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 very pigmented. Very pigmented. This is the best blush color that she's made for our complexion. So what I do, did I miss anyone? Kindly take. Oh, thank you. Thank you so much, Crystal. Thank you so much, everyone. Please, thumbs up. Thumbs up, please. So I used, now sometimes I'm a little too heavy with this, but I absolutely love these right here. And these are the older palettes. These are the diamond and blush palettes. Whoopsie. Right, so I have both of them, and these are staples. I bought these, one was last year, and I bought one the year before last. And I tell you what, this one right here, I'm trying to not make sure that the mirror doesn't reflect too much, but this one right here, this color, it scares people away, but the darker you are, the better it actually portrays on your skin, and you can rub it in and it gives all that nice glistening on the highlight, especially the top portion of your cheek. These are all cream products here, with the exception of this is the cream to powder, I believe it is. And then these colors right here. So I have done what I've taken this, the reddish color in here, put it as a base, and then I've dusted my skin again. This gives me a beautiful, where is it? This one right here. This cream, I used to think it wouldn't work for me. Just like this lipstick, I didn't think it was gonna work for me. But once I started playing with the colors, especially if you have bronzer underneath, great. If you're lighter complexion, great. They work for your skin. This is all highlighter, darker highlighter, brighter highlighter, and these I've used on my eyes as well. Now, I don't know if they're safe for eyes. I'm just saying, I used it, okay? So that's that one. And then the second one is this one here, and this one here is the palette. And of course, these are beautiful colors for spring, guys. Spring, my makeup is a little different. During the fall, my makeup is a little more contoured, right? Even though it doesn't look that way, but I put more contour on during the spring. I put color all the way. I bring my color up on top of my concealer, going across my nose to give a more blushed appearance. If you think about like Pippi Longstocking, I think, you know, the girl, I have freckles. So the girls with the freckles and stuff like that, when you blush, when you're younger, it looks, all of this right here is enlightened and it's red or burgundy or whatever color, right? So I put makeup all here. And today I did the same thing. Today, now you don't have to spend Natasha Denona money, although these were on sale for $44.95, I think. Okay, these were 50% off on her site. This right here, it is gorgeous. This is by Butter London, and it is a cheek gloss. And that is all I am wearing on my cheeks today. That is it. That is all I am wearing on my cheeks today. I'm not playing. You got to keep it closed so that it doesn't dry out. But that's what it looks like. It's a jelly. You tap it on, and it blends out really quick. I got every single color I could get my hands on, including the highlighting versions. So I'm gonna be, and they stay on, you can see, I've had my makeup on, well, it took me about an hour to do the wig. I started about 1:30 trying to do, you know, get my makeup done because I knew I was gonna struggle with the wig. But yes, you can wear what you, yeah. Absolutely, absolutely, yes. Oh gosh. You cannot beat a good palette. Yes, I am as well. I am as well. So those are the cheek products, right, that I have. Now, you can do eyes or cheeks first. I do either or. But one thing I don't go without, since it knocked out of the park, since it came out, Fenty bronzer. Whenever I travel with this. So if I forgot blush, if I forgot my bronzer, or I don't have time to do my makeup or whatever, I could use this one. So this one is the Mocha Mommy, which is the darkest one at the time. They've got darker colors right now. But this one I bought, and I take this everywhere I go with me. And the reason why is because if I forget to put on makeup, or I'm running late and I don't have time to put on my makeup, this functions as eyeshadow, it functions as blush, it functions as bronzer, it functions as contour. Yes, my dears, this red color right here, it does all of that. Yes. And so what I've learned is I could take my eyebrow pencil, yes, my eyebrow pencil, rub it on my hand right here, put it up in the corner right here if I don't, and then brush it out to give me just a slight contour, and then I put this on top. So yes, Fenty bronzers, absolutely stunning, stunning, stunning products. Bobbi Brown is the GOAT, but Fenty coming a close. Yeah, second. And then the eyes, guys, spring eyes. Do I have some stuff for you? I've got not one, but two of Pat McGrath's palettes, right? Divine Rose 1 and 2, okay? I got both of them here. One of them is in a broken box that I refuse to switch the box out. That's why it's like that. But love these colors. Now, this one, is this the one I'm wearing today? Yes. So, oh, wait, I take that back. I do have something on my cheek. Besides the gloss, I popped. Where is it? This one. I popped this color right here, right on top right here. And as you can see, look how pink it looks in here. And look at that. You can't really tell that I have it on, right? So this palette, if you don't buy nothing else from Pat McGrath, if you say I want nothing from her, she's too expensive, or whatever you're going to say. If you buy nothing else, get your hand on one of these. I would go with this one here, which is the two. Guys, this color right here is what I'm wearing. Look at that. My eye goes from green to pink. Green to pink. I have this pink right in the corner of my eye right here. And then I have this gold on the inner corners of my eyes. And I don't think you can see it a little bit. Right? This palette, spring in a palette. That's this right here. Now, if you say, you know what, Pam, I don't dig the night, you know, the colors and all of that kind of stuff. I'm a little more neutral. Well, I got another one for you right here. This is Mother Pat's. This is number 7, which is Divine. Is it Divine Sun? I think that's what it's called. Midnight Sun, right? This one here, I use for work a lot, okay? And the reason why, whoa, y'all saw that, right? Yeah. Fell right out. This one here, I had when it launched. And what I noticed is that this green looks well. Use it with the red and then this neutral color right here. And then some days when I'm rushing, all I do is I take this dark color and all across the eyelid. Okay? So hopefully if you purchase this, that's what just happened ain't gonna happen to you. Okay? Yeah. But I've had this palette for a while, even though that really should not have occurred. So I think other people have had that issue too. So there you go. This one here is a more neutral palette. As you can see, where is it? This color right here. You see how the shimmer, it changes. So if you want something like, let's say you're going out in the afternoon for evening drinks or something like that, and you want something really quick, you can pop this color on, that nice peachy glow. I think it will do really well on any skin tone. Let's see here. Is it really? This one or the rose? I can hear them. I can hear them. And these things are not stored poorly, mind you. Oy. Let's see here. I don't own one, but it's on your wish list. I swipe them in store. Okay. Okay. Oh, gosh. Trini X and Jump Up on your chair. Yes, I love it. I do. I do love beauty. I love fragrance. I love beauty. I just love it. And wait till I show y'all the fashion, guys. Yes, Midnight Sun. It's a beautiful one. Hi, Nadia. Hi. So, the other one that I have to show you guys that I take with me, pretty much an easy palette if you are looking at Natasha Denona, and is this one here. And this is the gold. Guys, I absolutely love this palette. It's a great summer palette and it's a great spring palette. For me, I'm scared to like tip this because I don't want this to fall out. But the reason I like these palettes the way this is because I could flip it all the way back. I could hold it like this, right? And I do, because I don't use the mirrors. As you can see, the sticker that comes with the mirrors is still on mine, right? And I've had this palette since it launched, okay? So what I do is I have my mirror or whatever, and I'm deciding, I kind of go by how I feel at the moment. And then sometimes with my finger, I just put them on, or I put it on my hand to see if I want to wear something like that. And then sometimes the colors that I'm wearing, it actually depends on what I'm wearing, the clothing. So I absolutely love this palette because it has a lot of different nudes, right? Has a lot of different nudes, a lot of different goals. And these two here, the two greens, well, it's actually a tri, 1, 2, 3, 4. These four colors right here has green bluish effects, including the shimmery ones. They're buttery smooth. They're like 2 years, 3 years old, I think. Yeah, I think this palette is 3 years old. Whenever it came out, that's when I bought it. And I'm telling you, I still use this. It's a very easy palette to use. It has a lot of goldenness, so you can get a little overwhelmed by it, but quick one shadow looks, This whole row right here. Where is it? Right here. This whole row. Quick one shadow looks. Pop a color, glitter, whatever you want. It's got it with you. So if you're traveling and all you want to do is have your lashes be the drama focus point and stuff like that, a great palette for the spring and summer. So let's see. Did I miss? Oh, I cannot forget the goat. Okay, I talked about bronzer and color on the cheek, guys. This one here, I don't go nowhere. This is Max Sun Power. I think this is, I'm trying to hit pan on this. These have so much pigmentation. So much pigmentation. And not only that, but the way they make your skin look, it's nice and smooth and sumptuous. It's not chalky, bakey, or any chalky, bakey, cakey. It's nothing like that at all. Not at all. Okay. This is the OG. This is Sun Power. And it has a mirror. It has a mirror here. So, you know, take it to work. You forget to put on blush. You put a little color on your cheeks and stuff like that. As we're getting older, I'm telling you, ladies and gents, color on the cheeks make you look younger. I'm just saying. If you have no color on the cheek, it makes you look paler. Blush is everything. If you ain't got no blush, you got to hush. Yes, Nadia. Hugs for everyone. Oh, thank you. Thank you, sweetheart. Thank you. Okay, so that's the makeup. I think I got all the makeup out of the way. Oh, no, I didn't. You notice that I don't wear any eyeliner without color, and there's a reason behind that. With brown eyes, the color green, it makes our eyes look really good. But I am venturing into colored contacts. So the reason why I don't have any on now is because I want it with my prescription in it so that I'm not playing around with the glasses, and that takes another whatever time for me to get that. But just the regular contacts, I like contacts, I like colored eyes. I just like changing up my look, right? But one of the things that remains staple is MAC color. These, I don't even know if they make these anymore. These guys, I have two of the different kind of blue. This one is a bright, this is a darker blue, right? And this one is a bright summer blue. And this one is the one, can you see? This is the one I have on right here. And then I popped some silver. And I created a wingtip with the silver. And normally I use this one just as a water liner. But I have about 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 wonderfully made. She had me buy these. I went to the store and I bought every single color I could get my hands on. The only color I could not find was the bright. It was a chartreuse green. That sold out like that. Yep, that's the one I really wanted. Now I put this on in the morning to go to work, the green. You see me when I do my makeup tutorials. That's the only liner I normally wear for work. 12, 14 hours later, eyeliner's still there, didn't budge. Doesn't pool in the corner of your eyes, doesn't pool in the corner of your eyes here or on the ends. It does not move, it does not transfer, it does absolutely not. These are called shadow sticks. Let me make sure that's what they're called, because maybe they still make them. I haven't shopped at MAC stores in a while. This is Pro Longwear Waterproof Color Stick. And so you can use them as shadows and whatnot. A staple in your spring and summer eye look. Colored eye pencils. You don't have to use this color, but colored eye pencils will boost the way your eyes look. Okay. So, you done got your face ready and stuff like that. Your hair, you know, got to be glued down and everything if you're wearing a wig. And you're like, okay, what do I do now? Well, you got to wear fragrance. And I got tons of fragrance out here. Tons of it. I was going to do like a haul, but one, two, three of my items didn't come in. So I'm still going back and forth on that. But, excuse me. One of the things that I talked about is accessories. Give me 1 second. Let me bring my accessories to you. Hold on 1 second. I'll be right back. Okay. I am back. Let's see, did anyone else come in that I missed? Because that's funny, Amina. Well, you made it back, my dear. Oh, gosh. Okay. So one of the things that I do, let me show you. I don't know if anybody else but me does this, but these hangers, right, where you can hang up all your clothing. Yep, I love these hangers. So I have about 5 or 6 of these. And what I wear during the summer, spring and summer, I'm going to stand up for a second. Okay, for the spring and summer, what I wear are jumpers. I cannot do without jumpers. These, the colorful ones, you can pick these up at any, basically at any store, really. Everybody carries these things during the spring and summer, right? And then the material has to be light, okay? So these, I like these types because they can be sexy where you don't wear anything underneath, right? Like no tops and stuff. You put the tape your chest down and whatnot. Or you wear a tank top underneath or a bodysuit, right? Or they can be like these. I like pockets. So I have a lot of these, as you can see. I love these things. My staple wear for the summer is easy breezy clothing. I don't like, now this one I want to go back on the hook. There we go. I don't like difficult clothing. And so let's drop that down here. I'll fix that later. The next item that I swear by during the summer is this right here. And that's these types of dresses. Okay, they're easy to put on. They're elasticized, right? Okay, and then the skirt is short. And this goes all the way down. This drags, even in heels. This drags. That's what I love wearing this. And of course, you know, it was orange tassels, so it was my favorite thing. So I have dresses like these and jumpers, long pants, jumpers, and stuff like that. Love, love, love wearing those items. Now, if you are like me and you like to shop for clothes and stuff like that, but you want your clothing to be something you could wear for a certain amount of time, what you want to do is you want to invest in statement pieces, not just jackets and things of that nature. You want to invest in statement accessories. And not, I don't buy expensive costume jewelry on purpose, okay? Not that I can't afford it. I just don't want to buy it. And you saw what happened to my palette. Can you imagine if one of my pearls fell out of my Chanel brooch or, you know, I would be devastated. But I invest in scarves. So this one here, I want to say, I forgot the name of the designer, and I hardly ever wear this one anymore. I used to have two and I sold one, but he was all the rage back in the mid-2000s. I can't find a tag. But he passed, McQueen, this is who this is by, right? He passed away, a British designer. Love, love, love these. I actually had two. I had this one, and then I had another one that was gray with the blue skulls on it, and I ended up selling that one. And I wish, I wish I hadn't. I absolutely love this. How I wear these, okay, so you see it's a decent size square. This is silk, okay, and my raggedy fingernails, I hope I don't snag it. But sometimes what I do is I'll cross it in a triangle like this, and I'll wear it as such. I can also wrap it like you do the Louis Vuitton scarves, like so, right? Something like that. There are different multitude, and there are tons of videos on YouTube on how to, you know, fashion scarves. But Alexander McQueen, that's who this designer is. I had a brain fart for a minute. Love, love, love this. Now, the other one that I love is this right here, and this is by Hermès. Okay, now this one is long and skinny, as you can see. But what I really love about this, let me bring it up close. Look at the colors, the colorway. It's got orange, blue, green, teal, black, yellow. Here we go, that's a good. So you could wear this with any color. You can even wear a red dress with this or red pants or, you know, put it tight, do like this, right? And put it on your around your waist and make it a belt, okay? So I'm telling you, these are the things that make my wardrobe, right? And one of the things that I absolutely, and you can see I still have the tag on some of these things because I haven't worn it yet. But this is by, I want to say this is, it's by Amelia Pucci. I think this is by Pucci. No, this is by Echo. I don't know if you guys remember the brand Echo. Look at how gorgeous that is. Beautiful spring colors, right? You can take this and you can wear a basic white t-shirt from Target. Those are my favorite t-shirts. I have one in every color from Target. Some jeans, right? Make sure that the neckline is sort of loose, you know, like a sort of a, you know, you don't care. You're not trying too hard, you know, that kind of stuff. A nice leather belt. You take this scarf and you wrap it around, you put it around your neck, or you could take it and you could put it in the loop of the pants, of the jeans, just tie it right there and that's it. I don't know, if maybe I'm the only one that does stuff like that. And then I have this one right here. This is mostly the one I wear for, this is a red, white, and this is by, is that Burberry? I think so. Who's this by? Nope, this is by Brooks Brothers. So I normally wear this scarf around Labor Day and stuff like that, July 4th, because it's red. Red, white, and blue. And then one of my pride and joys, this I bought, my hubby bought for me, came from Cancun. And this is by a designer from there. Her name is Piñera Covalin. This one I've not worn, but this one I have. So, whoopsie. Okay, where's my fan? I is hot. See how pretty that is? Look at that. And what's more spring than butterflies? Right? Gorgeous. So, and I have it in blue as well. And this one is a skinny one. And I have not worn this one yet. Don't know why. So the other thing that I like when it comes to scarves, hold on, guys. Let me get my fan because I'm burning the heck up. The other thing that I like when it comes to scarves is the Louis Vuitton scarves. Now, Louis Vuitton and Pucci are my two favorite pinks. They always make the best pinks. So this is by Emilio Pucci. This is by Emilio Pucci. And then I have Louis Vuitton, these bandeaus right here. I have several of those. And then I also have this scarf I got for Christmas a couple years ago. This one I absolutely really love. I thought about, how do you call it? When you put it in like a box, a shadow boxing it. Because I saw it at Louis Vuitton store on the wall. Look at that. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful for the spring. Look at that. Gorgeous. So, needless to say, simple top, simple bottom, and then you put on a scarf or a beautiful belt or something to that effect, and it will take your outfit from A to Z very, very quickly, okay? So I'm gonna, if you are in a cooler area, who remembers these denim scarves by Louis Vuitton? This is old school, guys. This right here, OMG. This is a huge scarf. Love it, love it, love it. During the spring and summers, when I wear this one, I have some others in different colors, and I wear those during the later part of the year. So I will put these. I'm going to just throw these in the corner, and I'll put them away later. All right. So, whoo, it's getting, I feel like Nelly is getting hot up in here. Hey, Beverly. Yes, they are, and they're great investment pieces. Yes, and I got that, we got that from the airport in Cancun. We were coming back, and I walked into the boutique, and it's called, you know, I was like, wow, these are pretty, and they were all up on the wall, like pinned up and stuff like that. I love that kind of art, like where you could put it, but I can't see spending all that money on a scarf. And I thought about doing it because I saw it at Louis Vuitton too. And I think Hermes, they do that too, where they put their scarves. I have another Hermes scarf that I haven't used yet because it's really, really pretty. And I don't want to get makeup on it because I have gotten makeup on almost everything that I've worn. Yes, it is. It is. You love jumpers. Yes, I have a lot of jumpers. I love jumpers. Me too, Lindsay. Okay, so when you have all of that stuff, let me show you the easiest stuff to wear, okay? You going out? You going out? Heels. If you're buying and you're investing in Jimmy Choo, Christian Louboutin, Prada, all of those brands, and you buy shoes that you can only wear with one outfit, that's a problem, okay? But I like colored shoes. So these I've had, God, for a long time, over 10 years probably. So I have these. Now the heels, you see the heels are a little, you could see, remember when platform was in style? Well, it's still in style for me, okay? So I've got these, and I've got, if you want to take it neutral, right? And these I really love because of the heel, right? The lace heel. These are YSLs. And these are really hard to come by. So I just kind of like, as soon as I found them, I snapped them up. And then I like this burgundy right here. So I've worn this to weddings. I've worn it to church. I haven't worn it just to go shopping or anything like that. But they're really comfortable to wear. They don't hurt my feet because of the platform, even though the heels are 5 inches probably. Yeah, by 5 inches. So these, I have about 5 of these. I love the colorways of these. I have orange, I have nude, I have orange nude, this color, purple, and a burgundy one that looks more very like more modern, I wanna say, because you lace it up at the front and stuff like that, just a different type. But yeah, these, and another brand, and Jimmy Choo right here, these right here, if you don't have a pair of hot pink shoes, get you a pair. I almost bought the Christian Louboutin, what's it called? Oh my gosh, it's not the simple. It started with a P. I almost bought those. They hurt like hell, but OMG, they had bright chartreuse, yellowish green color. They had the pink. They had a bright red. They had the graffiti. And I'm like, ooh, those are cute. Ooh, those are cute. But I have a lot of Christian Louboutin sitting in the closet looking pretty at me because they're not the most comfortable shoes. Jimmy Choo, Prada, Saint Laurent. There are other brands that are much more comfortable. The red looks great, but so get yourself some bright pink shoes that will amp your outfit up. Some jeans and a white shirt or a black t-shirt or a button-down shirt or whatever, and some bright sandals or pumps knocks it out the park. I'm telling you people. But you say, Pam, you know what, I don't like color like that. Hold on, I missed some comments. I'm so sorry. Hold on 1 second. Yes, it is. It's gorgeous. And they're comfortable. They're comfortable to wear in storage and you rotate. Okay. Yes. We were talking last night on Nika's Live about YSLs because she's in Kansas and I'm in Lawton. And people don't really wear these stuff out here, but I wear mine. I pay for them. I wear them when I can. I'll tell you what's my most worn pair of heels. And I mean, most worn pair of heels are these. These are by Stuart Weitzman. These wedges are the most worn pair of heels that I own. I have the cost per wear. Whenever I'm buying something very expensive, I always think about the cost per wear. I always do. And so I will tell you these, my dears, these wedges are comfortable. They're high, yes, but they are very comfortable. And because of the neutral color, goes with almost every single thing in my closet. Almost. Another pair are these. And these are another pair of wedges. And these here, see, they come up high up on the ankle, right? But you see the detail? It's like crackled gold. So this is a little more dressier. So if you're wearing something in gold or you're wearing all white or something like that and you want something comfortable, and they're light. The cork is lighter than, if you find shoes with straws and stuff like that, you'll notice that they're not as comfortable. The cork, much, much more light and comfortable. So you won't topple over, you know, because wedges, you know, you could trip with those. So these right here, apps, I wear these a lot too. But my most worn flats are these. And I keep the paper in it to keep the the shape. And these are also by Stuart Weisman. And I absolutely love these shoes. I'm very careful with them not to scuff them up. I grab these up. I want to keep these white, but I don't know how to keep them white. So without staining this way. These right here, guys, I wear a lot of going out and stuff like that. Not just going to the grocery store and stuff, because I don't want to get them wet or whatever. And so that's the fashion part of our little show where we're talking about what we're going to be wearing this spring and summer. Jumpers, long dresses that flows in the wind and are comfortable. And you don't have to spend a lot of money. I tell you, if you go to like nice little boutiques in a mall and stuff like that, you know, you'll find stuff that you can wear and it's comfortable and you won't, especially if it has pockets. I love pockets. No issues whatsoever. Okay. So let's see here. Oops. Let me go this way. Yeah. All right. So totally bling. Yes. I love me some bling. I do. Use old toothbrush with, okay. Thank you, Teresa. I will try that because I've always worried if you buy the stuff, you know, when you go to like Foot Locker or something like that, they have like the stuff to keep like tennis shoes white. I always worry about those getting messed up. Okay. Yes, me too. I was about to buy the Gucci slip-ons, the mules, and I changed my mind. I decided not to buy those. Hi, shoe lady. Hi. Guys, again, thank you so much for joining. If this is your first time here, please make sure you hit the like button. And my drink is by Tropical Cafe. I am drinking a smoothie. So we talked about skin fabulousness, keeping our skin fabulous. We talked about clothes and fashion, shoes, and all of those scarves. I love, love, love scarves. And what we're, let's see, Marilyn says she can't wear heels because she has a weak ankle. You can wear flats or you can wear the wedges that are low if you want to. You don't necessarily, just the color. I think that's the message I'm trying to bring across. Gold, something nude, something bright and colorful would be real. That would amp your outfit up. I wear a lot of color anyways, but I'm telling you, if you like basic colors, you like the basic color spectrum, blue, black, brown, white, and black, you'll find that if you are wearing things that has colors, your shoes are different, your artistic, your scarf is different, it pops that outfit really quickly. Pops that outfit up. Yes. And you can wear lower wedges. You don't have to wear the high wedges. Stuart Weisman carry lower wedges. There are places that carry lower wedges. Okay, so let's get into fragrance. So I was going back and forth thinking about, okay, should I do the haul? And yeah. And I decided I wasn't going to do the haul yet because I really do want to have all of the stuff, all my birthday items in to do that. But what I do want to talk about are fragrances that I think that behave. Fragrances that I think, you know, that I hauled recently, right? That I hauled recently. I got this one right here, guys. I have been on the phone to every CCO trying to find me a bottle of this. This is... This is Velvet Orchid. All I got is this one. And if I buy the big bottle, it's less money that I'm spending cost per utilization, right? See, tried the Gucci mules. They were too heavy. They were returned. Oh, okay. I'm glad I didn't buy them. This fragrance, guys, it's really, really pretty. I was not expecting to like this as much because I actually don't like the Tom Ford Black Orchid as much as everybody else did. It's not like, I'm just not sold on, it just didn't do it for me at all. And I thought something was wrong with me. Turns out it's wrong, something wrong with everybody else. But one of the things that I noticed is that this fragrance, some of Tom Ford, either they're repackaging or they're just not going to make them anymore, because I'm not seeing a lot of things anymore in the stores. Anyways, this is Velvet Orchid. Guys, this is sweet. It's floral. It's woody. It has got honey in it. It's got rum in it. It's still got the depth that the Black Orchid, if you like Black Orchid, has in it. It still has that depth to it. But one of the things that I really like about it, it is a little more floral, and it's not as cloying on me. The rum and the honey in the top notes gives you that heavy vibe to it, but then the citrus of the mandarin and the lemon or lime, it just lightens it up. I absolutely really, really enjoy this fragrance. I've worn it. I wore it last night a little bit for about 4 hours. I said, let me put some of this on. I put it on and I still really liked it. The Black Orchid Floral, that's in the middle note. You can smell it like you're smelling the black bottle, the actual Black Orchid. But the Rose and the Jasmine, I already have something on. I'm not going to spray this one here. I think it's a good fragrance for spring and summer. In my opinion, it goes well. The colors, the pinks, the oranges, the fuchsias, you know, the citrines, those type of colors, the melons, that kind of color, you know, this fragrance would blend nicely with that. Now, fragrances that are cost effective, I think, for the spring and summer, these two right here, these are Signorina, okay? This is the Eau de Toilette, and this one here is the Infiori. Guys, these two together, all of them, you can blend them, you can mix them. But these two in particular, this is a nice light scent, meaning that if you're not somebody that likes really heavy scents, you like to smell your perfume, but you like it fleetingly, you don't like it like, you know, heavy, like everybody can smell it. This is a good one for you. And it's a lavender color bottle, right? This is the Infiori. This has a lot more sweetness to it. It's light as well, but it's sweeter and it has a little more longevity than the one in the purple bottle, which is the Eau de Toilette. Absolutely love the bottle. Okay. These are the only two I kept in my collection because I'm trying to dwindle down my collection. I was heading to 200 and that was just not good. Hi, Ty. Hey, how are you? Thank you very much for joining. Hi, Ida. That's okay. If you don't mind, please watch the replay. We're not going to be on very much longer. We're going to be on for about 30 more minutes, and then we're going to get off. Is a new... Okay, yes, there is a new one in a black bottle. There's also one in a black bottle as well that is the Mysteriosa, and that one isn't new. Hi, Marsha. Hi. Okay, thank you. Thank you very much. So these two are great budget friendly. You can get these for probably under $20 at Ross, TJ Maxx, and Marshalls. That's Signorina Eau de Toilette. Okay. And this one is the Infiori. This is a little more floral, sweeter, you know. Now, one that I think that everyone, if you're looking into getting into something a little more niche, but you want it, you don't want to spend a lot of money, I got something for you too. Guys, I talked about this. All week I'm talking about this brand. And this is a brand new, this is part of my haul. You know, so you might see it one more time. I'm just saying, you know, or two or three more times. But guys, these two right here. The Taliaferro. If you have not gotten your nose on this brand, if you have not gotten your nose on this here, guys, you need to. I have two of them. I have room 129. Oh, my goodness. These things smell so good and clean and soapy and sheepy. Woo! I'm going to put the link. I always do that. I put the link down in there because y'all need to discover this. Y'all need to discover this line. Just like I talk about Maison France now. Not Maison France. Maison de Darius is still my favorite. It's still my favorite, you know, independent house. But Taliaferro is good. Maya Angelou is also good. But Taliaferro just, knocked it out of the park for me. I was not expecting it to be that good. So I have cloud nine and room 129. I am highlighting right now the page, and I'm gonna put it in the description bar so that you guys could copy paste it if you need to and save it and check out his site. And guys, I paid $50 for these 250 milliliter bottle, and I really like them. So I have, I have cloud 129. Here we go. Room 129. That's bubblegum cherry, and bubblegum cherry and something else. I can't remember the third note. It's only three notes in it. Bubblegum, cherry, and powder. That's the three notes in this one here, and it is beautiful. And then the other one, which is cloud nine, that's a little more, it sounds like it's more gourmand, but to me, that's a little more grown up. It's a little more grown up. I'm pulling it up right now. And then there are other, there's number one called Cool. The other one is a custom scent. You can make your own custom scent for $175. He will make your own scent for you. And that, like, it's a, there's a consultation and all sorts of stuff that goes into that. But right now, I'm just discovering his main line. And this one here is Sugar Cookie, Amber, and Vanilla. And that's what Cloud 29 is. And guys, these fragrances, love them. I am so thankful that chai, every time I look at them, I can't help myself but spray. For the cost, I think it's really good fragrances. Now, they project, they keep falling down. They project really well. If you overspray, they'll project very far. But I noticed that I appreciate the fact that I could constantly smell. I remember spraying my shirt going to work, and I was like, oh, this smells really nice. It smells really nice. You know, I was going back and forth. It smells really nice and stuff. And then about 12 o'clock, so I had like two meetings, and then about 12 o'clock, right before lunch, I could still smell it, but it's more like a personal scent. And so that's what I enjoyed about these. The other one I want you guys to talk about or think about trying is this one, is Soul Cafe by Savoir Faire. Another black perfumer, another indie brand, another, well, the full bottle I don't have. I just have the 10 milliliter. But with all this perfume I have, if you have more perfume than me or close to what I got, you don't need a whole lot of perfume. You know, we talked about that already. You don't need a big bottle. Oh, gosh. I'm trying to make it look a little more aesthetic. You know, I got my little pink flowers over here. That's my heart. Let's see. Yep, Nathan made me that heart. That's up there. Yeah, I'm trying to make it a little more aesthetic looking. You guys tell me in the comments, you know, after this, if you'll like it, if not. But yeah, we're getting ready to move, and I need like big cabinets for my perfumes. And I don't see the need to buy one. And then, you know, I'll wait till I get to Texas to purchase one. Mm-hmm. But I am thinking about getting a couple more bookshelves, putting it inside the closet, and then storing the fragrances inside the bookshelf in the closet on top of my bench where I sit down to get dressed. Because right now that's covered with perfume and I have nowhere to sit. So I sit on a stool to get dressed or in the bedroom. So I've been trying to figure out what I want to do. Do you like it? Got my little lights going on and stuff like that. My little fairy lights. I thought about putting curtains up, and then I was like, nah. Oh, gosh. Hi, Natalie. From 129, I do get a lot of bubble gum from it. Yes, but it dries down to a beautiful, beautiful scent. It doesn't stay. So I think of Bubba Yum. If you remember that bubble gum, that powder that's on the coat, that coats that gum as you're eating it, you know, like as you just bite into it, that is what I get from room 129. thank you very much. Oh, thank you so much. Is that brand of it? I don't know if he's available in the UK, but you can reach out to him on Instagram and ask, and more than likely you can arrange something for him to send stuff out to you. Oh, thank you so much, Natalie. I worked hard on that because I'm not really, you know, I'm the wall. You want to figure out what kind of paint what kind of tile you want, what kind of wooden floors you want, what kind of bricks to put on the outside of the interior of your house, how to build your fireplace. I'm your girl. What type of floorboards you need to have, you know, what type of sink to buy, what type of sink faucets, what type of toilets, what type of stoves, refrigerators, that kind of stuff. I am your girl. This right here, I'm just learning how to do. I'm just learning how to do this. I love like carpentry and masonry and that type of stuff. I know my grandmother, you know, we used to do that type of stuff, painting and all that stuff. And I like, you could change up a room with paint, not just the wall paint, but I like murals on walls. I did a couple of art pieces, you know, and people wouldn't even notice it until they walked in. I was like, that's pretty cool. Yeah, that's, you know, so I could take kitchen tiles and yeah, I like that kind of stuff. Creating tiled entryways in my head. I don't physically do it. I can just design it in my head. Yes. Hi, Phaedra. Hi, thank you for joining. So let's move on. So those are the reasonably priced Soul Cafe, room 129. And Cloud Nine from Di Taliaferro, Soul Cafe from, this is Chris Classics, and his this is called Savoir Faire is the name of this company, right? And I only have a 10 milliliter. I absolutely love this. Okay, new to me, loving it. Again, this right here, I like it better than the Black Orchid. This is Velvet Orchid. I prefer this. Right now, I never thought I would say this, but as you can see, she's got a little dent in her, just a slight dent. Moschino. This is a great, if you are outdoors, if you ride bikes, if you go outside and you're an outdoorsy type of person, if you like sitting down and fishing by the lake, if you like boating or kayaking or canoeing on the lake, if you like those type of things, but you still like to smell good because you don't want to smell like the lake because you know the lake has that fresh, funky smell. I'm just saying. It does, right? And you want something that's going to trail behind you as you're going, even if it's something like you like running or doing yoga outside. Guys, this is a great fragrance for that. This is Moschino Toy 2. Last year, I bought this and I was like, yeah, not feeling it so much. But I kept it because of the bottle. And then I pulled it out more recently and I started layering it. Believe it or not, I'm layering this fragrance with this right here. This is the House of Sillage. This is Whispers of, I believe it's Admiration. Okay, the one with the white cap. I layer these two together. And I like the scent that I get. As a matter of fact, I'm going to layer it right now. I like the scent that I get. I was playing around. Y'all know I do that. I go into my closet and I play around with fragrance that I own to see what type of fragrance I can come up with in my head. Ooh, that smells so good. And this one, it has a weed-like smell to it. It's very outdoorsy. It's very outside nature. It's warm. Is this Whispers of Admiration? No, I'm sorry. Whispers of Innocence. Whispers of Innocence. Let's see. Did I miss anyone? No, I did not. You have Toy 2 Bubblegum on the way. Okay. I have not smelled that yet. I haven't, you know, so I'm thinking I might get it, but I'm going to wait until it gets to the stores before I do that. The little black. Okay. Okay. That one's a male and it smells. I think the male version smells better than this, but I still like this. Yes. You have that one? Yeah. It's a good one. It's a really good one. It's a really good one. Yes. OMG. Mixing those two together, I like it because what happens with this one, it's not a favorite. A lot of people cannot stand this one here, the Whispers of Innocence. And I'll tell you the notes. Whispers of Innocence. think what's in this fragrance that people don't like is the beeswax element to it, and it has a slightly animalic vibe. So the lemon and the fruitiness of Toy 2, I think it tempers this fragrance, because now this, right, I mean, you don't have to layer it, right? But I like these two layered together, and I also like these two layered together. And this is the House of Siage. This one is the Whispers of Admiration. No, Lord, I can't think. Enlightenment. I don't know my House of Siage anymore. What's going on with me today? I am going to layer them again. And I let that sit for a little. Yeah, those two smell good together as well. It's just unique. It doesn't smell like anything I have in my closet at all. Nope. So this smells, you could smell the, you could definitely smell the Moschino, and you can definitely smell the Whispers of Innocence, the two of them together. This has a more warmy, I think it's a honey, the beeswax, that combination. A lot of folks aren't really feeling it at all, because I hear that that's probably the, besides Nika, that's the least favorite. I think Nika's was the one I like, which is Whispers of Guidance. But the Whispers of Innocence is the one that not a lot of people like, because it has like a medicine-y vibe to some people. And, you know, they just were, it got the low, I think it's got the lowest ranking of all the House of Siage's fragrances. So, yeah. And the other thing that I would recommend, though, is if you're wanting to try House of Siage, they have these kits right here, right? Now, they have the, what you call the sample kit, where they come in like very small 2 milliliter ones, and those are less expensive. It's like $25, and I want to say $35 or something like that for it. But these here, if you like the Whispers of the Garden collection for the spring, because a lot of flowers are in that one, you know, very spring, summery type vibe. You can get yourself these, get yourself a decanter, or you can just take these and go your happy, merry way with them. Very easy to travel with, okay? And one thing I have to talk about that I keep forgetting to talk about in all my videos. Off. You're gonna get yourself in some trouble and be in the cage in a minute if you don't stop. Hi, D'Angelo. See here. D, you're the expert. You are the expert. Hi, Indecents. Yes. So when you are traveling, most of the time we do our travelings when spring, summer, and during the fall for Thanksgiving and, of course, for Christmas. Last year, of course, we didn't do a lot of traveling. Oops. I purchased these. These are Sonia G's. And I got the, I didn't purchase these. These were a Christmas present from my husband. And this is the shorter version. This is the Christmas collection that she came out with. The wood is, oh my God, beautiful artisanal work, okay? This is an eyeshadow brush. You just need this. You don't even need the rest of it. You just need this. Put your eyeshadow on. Tilt it to the side. Hold on. Right? Put your eyeshadow on. Tilt it to the side. You just wipe it off on a squeegee cloth or a cheesecloth or a paper towel. Right? Tilt it this direction. You see that? Right? Tilt it that direction. Use it to contour your eyes. You punch the color in and then you flip up, contour your eyes. Clean the brush off if you need to. You come underneath and you brush underneath with the shadow. That's if you just want one. Now, I think it's only sold in a set. Okay? And in the set, I gotta put my spectacles on because I can't read. The writing is superimposed. So this one here, I said it was the shadow. So this is the Jumbo Blender. This is a blending brush. And then the next one is the Mini Booster, okay? And as you see it's round, but it's also got a slight dome shape to it, right? So this you could use to contour your eyes if need be. Guys, when I put my glasses on, you know, I can see myself clear. I don't know why I don't do that more often. And this one here is a mini base, right? You can put on your foundation, powder foundation with it. I like the inexpensive Real Techniques and other types of brushes to put my foundation on with. And I do have like some Marc Jacobs and stuff like that, but I don't use my Sonia G's to put my foundation on. But this is the base brush. And if you notice, look how small that is. And you know why this is that small? Because technically you don't really need a big brush to put on base. But for me, I like big brushes because I like to be done quickly. I'd be all day with this and I don't want to do that. Okay. And then it also has in the set here, it is the classic face. And this is like a powder brush. So you can use this to set under your eyes, set the line right here, right? Your marionette lines under here, chin, tap, 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 forehead, right? And you could contour your cheek as such, right? You can contour your cheek. You can even press this, like so, right? Contour the sides of your nose if you need to. But look at that. Gorgeous brush. And they feel really good. I haven't used them yet, like I said. And then the last one in the set, I think it's the last one, is it? Yes, it's the last one in the set is the, this is a flat definer. And you can use this to put color on the interior of your eye, like here, right? You can use this to put eyeliner on, under here, on top. You can do that with it. You can also use this to define by placing color, pigment. Look at that shadow, guys. Look at that. Now it's green. Now it's pink. Now it's green. Now it's pink. That's a Pat McGrath Divine Rose, too. Love it. Or one of them. Okay. So those are those eyeshadows. Okay. So, yep, that combination is really nice. Combination is really nice. Another fragrance that I would recommend, and you could find it right now, I don't know, I think Neiman Marcus, and this is Mon Bloom. I talked about this a lot. I shared this with some of you, but I don't know if you guys like this. Is tuberose heavy. It really is. But it is so nice and sweet. So if you like really thick, sweet smells, this will be good for you. And this is Mon Bloom by Ramon Monegal. You love the Sonia G brush. Okay, yes, it is perfect for travel. It is. Oh, yes, Mighty. Even a dog gets in trouble. Yes. So this is the time we do a lot of traveling. We don't want anything. We want easy clothes to wear. We want easy accessories such as those. Oh, thank you, Indecence. Yes. I love it. I love it. Nice and sweet. Mm-hmm. Has that nice sugary vibe to it too. I think I like sugary stuff and fragrances. But what I noticed is that, you know, we're moving, we're doing all, this is the time of the year movement happens. Spring and summer, you know, and you want to be beautiful. You want to not have anything that you're going to be thinking too hard about. That's how you want to vibe. You don't really want to be stressed out about what you're gonna wear, how you're gonna wear something, you know. And so that's why all those scarves, with the exception of the blue one, I have never used, and that's coming out this year. So I'm gonna pull that out. I think I'm gonna wear that with all white, all black, something to that effect, and wear it as a long, you know, tie, and have it like I call it the cowboy tie, where you like you put in a triangle and you let it droop. I like that look, and or droop on one side of the shoulder. I like that look too with scarves. But that's what I'm thinking I'm going to do with that one in particular. And then fragrances, I decided I was going to use a lot of my, no, I love all my House of Sillage, but I'm going to start pulling these out and do the Whispers of the Garden collection, start wearing those, especially this time of the year. I think it's going to be much more beneficial to use it this time of the year as opposed to during, I mean, you could wear them anytime, but instead of wearing them during the colder, you know, months where you want to be cuddly and stuff like that. You want to wear these. And that's what it's for. If you look at the bottles, right? That's what they're designed for. They're designed for that. Beautiful, beautiful, beautiful. And I am going to be dipping into this. I don't know. I might. This is a big bottle. Look at that. It's a big bottle. I've only, you know, this week and last week, I think. I really wasn't expecting to like this as much as I did, because I was going back and forth like, I don't know. I got Dolce & Gabbana Light Blue. I got Moschino I Love Love. I've got Lyra. you know, I've got those, I've got other lemony stuff. And this has a slight lemon vibe to it too, the Soul Cafe. It has a subtle, like, citrus vibe to it as well. So I'm like, you know, I don't really need that, you know. And that was actually, the reason I was playing with it is because I was pulling it out to test it to see if I wanted to get rid of it. You know, if I wanted to gift it to somebody else and sell it. Oh, that is, that's true. D'Angelo, I was going to say D'Angelo. Yes. Did I miss anyone? Let's see here. Nika says, yes. Yes, you are. You are. Yes, Jen, it is. And I have the baby bottle too. Oh, gosh. Yeah, that is a big bottle. But I am loving these, guys. I cannot speak more highly about these fragrances. OMG. Talia Farrow, give it a try. It's $50 right now. That room 129, as soon as you smell the nozzle, I smell Kool-Aid. That's what it resonates with me, is Kool-Aid. I don't know about others, but that's what I smell at first. I know it's the bubblegum that's doing that, but I smell Kool-Aid. It's bubblegum powder, and I smell Kool-Aid. You know, that strawberry one that you, that had the sweetness to it that you wanted to put in your mouth, you open the pack and you pour it into your mouth. That's what I smelled. OMG. Oh, you know what else? I think I really want to wear this summer. That's affordable, guys. Right here. This, I think, is going to be, because remember when I talked about it day before yesterday, was it Friday? I said, I noticed that it's intense, but it doesn't smell like the original. And I think it's got a citrus vibe in it with that rose. I smell a lot of rose with this flower. So I think this will be a good pretty fragrance for this spring and summer, the Edo. Love it. Nika's the pusher. Oh gosh. You picked it up? When did you get it, and how do you like it? How do you like it? How is it wearing on you? You really like it? You kind of like it a little bit? Don't like it much? And these scents knows her stuff. Yes, indeed. She does. Yes, I like it. I absolutely do. Yes. You know, I think that that's one of the things that I really appreciate about, you know, designer fragrances. You know, I am, you know, I got a lot of niche fragrances and stuff, but I'm finding myself, you know, like I mentioned the other day, something's reminding me of certain things. Niche is the way to go. But there was a discussion. I watched a video last night. It's called, her name is, it's MJ. Her name is MJ. I think it's Maria is her name. But I was watching her channel last night, and she was talking about, she did a video about niche fragrances that she wasn't really feeling, or it like basically was a waste of her time. And some of my favorites were on there. And I'm like, oh, well, it's fragrance is subjective. But a lot of people in the comment section were saying they were getting the same, kind of like me and, you know, Maison Francis Cook's John Baccarat 540. I like the fragrance. I just can't smell it. Okay. It's like David Copperfield, like I said in the video, right? So if you can go with Dossier, if you can go with Okja, if you can go with the oil perfume, you know, if you can go with those other places, maybe that's the route you want to take. But to say that niche fragrances are a waste of money, I would not go that far, because I think that niche fragrances comes in a variety of packaging or a variety. It's a variety of people. What makes something niche? What makes something niche is that it's not a designer, right? What makes something indie? You know what I mean? So that's just kind of my take on it. It's just my take on it. Maybe I'll get him to come on live with me. Because I'm not as bad as Nika. I'm not as bad as Nika. Nika already got me in trouble. You see, I got put in the corner over here, you know, because of Nika. It used to be Dr. Rose, now it's Nika. Oh, gosh. Dr. Rose and Joanne. Now it's all on Nika. Oh, gosh. No, you're not the only person in the world. I don't not like it, though. I will say that. I don't find the fragrance offensive or anything like that. I just think that for the cost of the fragrance, it should last longer. It should project longer. But it doesn't do that on my skin. On other people's skin, it does. Because a lot of people stand for Baccarat Rouge 540. They call it their number one fragrance. It's just not mine. You know, so you're not the only person in the world. There are other people. I prefer Tiziana Torrenzi Spirito Fiorentino. I haven't smelled the Baccarat Rouge 540 X-Trait, but I think, no, not that I haven't smelled it. I don't own it. And I think that the Spirito Fiorentino smells very similar to it. Tiziana Torrenzi smells very similar to it, except that one is a lot stronger. It is a lot stronger. A lot stronger, in my opinion. And then as it dries down, it stays smelling a lot thicker and heavier than what Baccarat Rouge 540 X-Trait is supposed to smell like. But then maybe about by the fourth hour, they start separating. They part ways. They no longer smell like each other. In my skin, they start changing a little bit where Baccarat Rouge starts disappearing. And Fiorentino, the sweetness of it, Spirito Fiorentino starts amping up. I don't know what it is that Paolo put in that thing, but that's what it does on my skin. Let's see here. It's okay. Yeah. I have the one that I opened the other day that was leaking, the Bubblegum Chic by Healy, by James Healy. And I really, really like that one. I actually layered this bubblegum with that one just to see what happened. And not a whole lot happened, to be honest with you. It just smelled like bubblegum. Yes, everyone, please thumbs up. Thumbs up the video. Please, please, please thumbs up. I only see 33. How do we have hundreds of people in here and only 33 thumbs up? Please thumbs up. You help me out. You help the channel out. You help everyone grow. Please thumbs up the video. Okay, so D'Angelo said he doesn't like it on her either. Yes, yes. Yeah, she's a Torrenzi for life. I love Tiziana Torrenzi. One of my favorites, of course, is Hallie, and I absolutely love that one. I love Kirk. I love Valet. I love all the ones that I have in my collection. I don't like any of them. I love all of them. Andromeda was one that took some liking, some, you know, a little bit of work to do, because to me it smelled strangely really masculine on me. But after I wore it like two or three times, I think it's because the bottle was new, not sure. I wore it about two or three times and then I was fine. Yeah. Yep. Yep. But I, you know, like I love Gentle Fluidy Gold. I love Le Beau. I love, Grand Soir. So, you know, it's not that it's bad or anything like that. I just can't smell it. I'm looking at it right now. I have the decant set. You know, and I've had this for some time. So I have the decant set right here. I keep it in its case and to save space. And as I'm smelling it, the first thing that comes to my mind is not Baccarat Rouge 540. It's actually, I'm thinking, okay, this is Tiziana Torrenzi. But the funny thing about the scent is that it disappears. It sweetens up and then it goes away. It sweetens up and then it goes away. And then I'll be moving around and I'll be like, oh, there you are. Oh, I forgot I wore you today. You know what I'm saying? And sometimes that's good, I guess. But for the most part, you know, you do want your scent to last about 4 hours on average. You want your scent to last on average 4 hours before it starts disappearing. you know, because that's like half the day has gone by if you're working and stuff like that. So you're not so concerned anymore, you know, about 4 hours, 4 to 5 hours. That's the average I would want my scents to last on me. What about you guys? The Bucantel line. I only have two so far. Hallie is gorgeous. I also like Hallie Bop. I like that one too. Hi. Oh, did not know that. Really? So he designed Baccarat Rouge to be like David Copperfield. Okay. Okay. Didn't know that. D'Angelo says he wants his fragrance to last about an average 6 hours. Okay. Random Lifestyle Vlog said the same. He liked to reappear to bring back the original magic of the fragrance. Okay. I get the intent, but I don't think I get the original magic of it, you know? Maybe if I knew this beforehand, I wouldn't be as frustrated as I am with it. Now that I know. That's really interesting. So it's quite animalic on you. 4 to 5 hours is good for you. You get tired of it. Yeah. And I like to try different stuff. I'm always spraying perfume on my body. Always. Yes. Now you see him. Now you don't. Where is he going? First he was on the stage. Then he's in the audience. Then he's in the rafters. Then he's outside the studio. That's David Copperfield. Okay. That's Baccarat Rouge 540. David Copperfield. Joyce, thank you for joining us, my dear. So we've got 85 people in the room. But when I look on my numbers, I only see 36 likes. Please thumbs up the video, guys. Please, if you're on Facebook, please thumbs up as well. If you are on Twitter, please thumbs up as well. And of course, on YouTube, please thumbs up the video. It would really help me out a lot. See, Natalie says we wear 4 to 5 different scents throughout the day, and I've done that before. Like I mentioned, I was playing around, like I had something else on, and then I started playing with the Moschino. And I was like, I looked at this bottle, I was like, oh, I want to talk about this tomorrow. So I sprayed this on, I was like, oh, okay, it's a little different. I can still smell this fragrance in here, the weedy, I call it weed smell, you know, like pretty flowers outside of the weeds. That's what I get with this fragrance. And then I put the Moschino on because I was, you know, moving fragrances aside of. That I think I don't really want anymore. Yeah. Yeah. And then I was like, oh my goodness. And I still like these two together. The oh yeah. So I like these two together. I love these. Again, the Talia Farrow guys, check out his site. I really enjoy his fragrances. Yes. We are. That's in our creative space, in our closet or on our bed. And that's the next fragrance I'm probably going to be getting from D. Talia Farrow. Bed. B-E-D. I think that's an acronym. Hold on. That's an acronym, guys. It's B-E-D. And it means become everyone's desire. Become everyone's desire. That's what it means. Okay, yeah, I'm Pam's buying that next. What does that happen at? OMG. Wow, that's kind of a sexy scent. So this is a fragrance inspired by clean sheets, fresh out the shower, intimacy, and a walk through a breezy bathhouse or beach house. Main notes are red currant, bergamot, and tea, which is funny because I get the bed scents with the other fragrance. The cherry room 129 is inspired by the individual who is looking for something new. This fragrance is delicious and charming for the daring socialite. I don't know if I'm a socialite though, but I love it nonetheless. Okay. All right. Let's see. What did the indecent say? Love. Oh, you love real ambergris. Okay. Well, guys, those are the fragrances that I wanted to share with you today. Let's see, we talked about those. There are a lot of fragrances that I think that would function. You know, if you are new to Prada, Part de la femme. Great one. Spring, summer time frame. If you are new to, or you like, Good Girl, or you think you like it, but it makes you sickly sweet, you know, sick afterwards, try Légère. My recommendation is to try Légère. The reason why is it's got citrus notes in it, and it would blend nicely with your skin and being outside. And then I would never, ever go, and I mean never, ever go without these. And this is by Guerlain, and this is Aqua Allegoria Neroleum Blanca, and this one is Aqua Allegoria Mandarin Basilic. These two are the only two I have and the only two I think I need from this line of fragrances. Nice and light and flirty and fresh. Whoops, hit my light. Flirty and fresh. So those are just some options for you if you're looking to buy something new. The ones that I talked to you about, I had in my collection. I do have I have some fragrances here that I hauled. I talked about some. I shared some already, but I want to do a birthday haul. So probably it may not be next weekend. It may be Friday. Well, Friday night we have is my next live, and that's going to be with the gentleman, a lady and the gentleman. So if you are free Friday night at 7 p.m., please tune in for that. I don't know what our topic is going to be yet, but I know that it's the first Friday of every month. We're trying to do, you know, trying to be consistent. So we're going to be on Friday night at 7 p.m. Now, Sunday should be the first Sunday of every month, and that's going to be the Hope Mamas, because we all like House of Sillage. So on Sunday at 4 or 5 p.m., I'll put the time up when I post it. We're going to be going live. It's going to be myself, Nika Marks, Cassandra Jones, Patrice McNeish, that's Perfumes with Pat, and then Dawn from Bougie Fragrance, five of us. We're going to go on every month. We do that on the first Sunday of every month. So please look forward to seeing that as well. Topic to be announced coming very soon. If you like my setup, please let me know. I worked hard at it. I think it looks cute. You know, little Chanel, little red bottoms and stuff. You know, I'm shading little hair. If you like my setup today, please let me know. If you have ideas for videos that you want to see me do, if I can do them, I surely will take them into consideration. It does take time for me to film and edit and stuff like that. I'm not as fast as everybody else, so please be patient with me. But I am hoping that you like the content that I'm bringing to you right now. If you have, again, ideas, or if you like what you see, let me know so that I know, you know, if it's too distracting for you, let me know. Okay. So my dears, we are at the 5:39 mark. We went a little over time today. See, Lindsay said, yes, I do too. We're 2 days sampling. Okay. Oh, thank you, Natalie. Yes, everyone, please thumbs up. We will see each other again very soon. I'm going to have a video popping up tomorrow. Please look for that. It should be out. I'll post what it's going to be this evening. I'm going to put the thumbnail. So it'll be a premiere. I'm trying to do more premieres. The reason why is because I like communicating with you guys in the comments, and that's why I do that. So please look forward to that. Again, if you have not subscribed to the channel, or if you like this kind of content, hit the like button. Make sure you share, okay? And my dears, take care of yourself, take care of each other, and I will see you in the next one. Bye!